I moved to Mexico in 1949, which was an extremely important move for me as research chemist for Syntex, a very small pharmaceutical company. And I'll probably get back to that later because that's where, even though I was there only 2 years initially, two of the most important things that I'd done in essentially within a year and a half occurred. The first synthesis of cortisone from a plant raw material, and the first synthesis of an oral contraceptive. But the last year before we moved was the first time that I had an extramarital affair. And again, I'm confessing nothing here that any person can read between the lines in my autobiography, or in fact, it doesn't take much imagination if you just read, well, not if you read who is who, because there doesn't give the correct data, but if you calculate the birth of my daughter and my marriage, my divorce date and my marriage date, you'll find there's something that doesn't match marriage date to my second wife. It was an affair. This was not a trivial, it was not a one-night stand, it was not a trivial extramarital affair, and I dare say that I probably thought at that time that I was truly fallen in love with a second woman without really having fallen out of love with the first one, who was an extremely kind of very nice woman. I mean, really just a princess of a person. But, you know, these things do happen, and it wasn't that I was philandering and looking for someone. I had met my second wife, Norma, at a party where, at a social gathering where my first wife was not present. I forgot why not, and we just happened to be dinner partners, and hit it off, and it worked. Well, the ironic thing is that she got pregnant. The ironic that it happened with me, that it isn't that we didn't practice birth control, actually used the condom. But I suspect that what happened at that time, the condom sort of slipped or something. Anyway, she got pregnant. And do you remember what that is at that time for a woman to become pregnant out of wedlock? A woman who was a professional woman, she was 6 years older than I. So she was in her early 30s and had not expected, of course, pregnant. She was working and literally decided abortion was illegal. And I don't even know what she considered an abortion, but it was totally illegal. She lived in the East Coast. We lived at that time. She was in New York, I was in New Jersey. Her home was in Boston. It was not a Catholic family, but it was a very traditional WASP, New England WASPish family. And she literally felt she had to leave her home and go to another place to be quite anonymous. Not that I mean starving, I didn't mean this, but in a place where no one would know her and she would give birth to the bastard child. She didn't call it that, of course, but that is what illegitimacy was visualized. This is within my lifetime, if we think about this. I mean, it was really the question of shame, of everything else. But it's ironic, which I learned on later, that that had happened to her mother earlier at some stage. I felt very bad about this, needless to say. But I was already in Mexico. And I did come back to the United States every once in a while professionally, and we saw each other. But I then really felt, and I have to probably say it was that, it was noblesse oblige rather than anything else, that I'd have to marry her. Now, that was not horrible. It was not a shotgun marriage because I thought I was also in love with her. So it was different. But I felt awful about what it would do to my first wife, whom I had to confront with this in Mexico and say, you know, I want to get a divorce because I want to marry another woman who is going to bear child of mine. And my first wife, that could have been an absolute bitch and she could have been outraged and so on, and I could have understood this, was really understandable. And she said, okay. And so much so that we got the same divorce lawyer. Now, in Mexico at that time, you could get a divorce in one day in the state of Morelos so we decided to do just this one day Mexican divorce, which sometimes rich people from the United States had in Mexico. We were living in Mexico City, so that was perfectly legal. There was nothing monkey business about it. And secondly, it was a mutually consenting divorce, so there was not something that would be questioned afterwards. And we literally got divorced in one day. And I remember driving with a lawyer from Mexico City to Cuernavaca and having lunch first. And as we sat at lunch, and he looked at us and he said, you know, it's none of my business, but are you really sure you want to get divorced? You seem to be so simpatico. This was, of course, all in Spanish. And we said, yeah, unfortunately, so we got divorced. And a week later, I flew to the United States and got married just in time. My wife had a child 3 weeks later. But it was legitimate. In the birth certificate, I was listed as father. Although, why is my daughter born in Hartford, Connecticut, when my wife was really otherwise in New York and I in Mexico City? And it was Hartford, Connecticut, because that is a place where she knew someone had gone there to have a child as a single mother, which of course she didn't. And then came to Mexico City when my daughter was maybe a month or 2 months old. So then we were married there.